Hello everyone, it's SystemCollapse, and I'm back yet again, playing Forever Stranded. And, done some stuff. Done some stuff with things. We're gonna get our angel ring today. That's the plan. Let's get to her. Let's take a look here. Can I get my point of view right? There we go. I haven't done a lot today. Today? In between videos. I built a couple more cobblestone generators because I realized, I wish I had more of those. They're expensive. Then I actually looked at the recipe. They're dirt cheap. It doesn't even use the buckets. So I just went ahead and made more. I made three more of them. So we got those now. Outside of that, I think everything else I did is downstairs. Let's go take a look. Because you'll see here, I actually have a golden lasso with a bat and a golden lasso with a squid in it. And those are things we need. Things we need to get our angel ring. So let's go take a look here. See here, I only got a creeper in here right now. I don't much care about him. Oh, I don't have any arrows right now. I actually made this squid farm. So, just a pretty standard squid farm. It's the kind of a falling wall squid farm. They come down here, they actually slowly drowned. Can you not do that? Because you're going to drown me. They just come down here, the water's falling down, and there's a half block of air down here. And in time, they will. He'll start to drown, and he'll die. And, drop his drops, and we're gonna need lots of squid ink later on anyway when we get into AE applied energistics, so it's a thing to have. Also should show you the rest because it was actually the more important part. What I had set up here on the ends, I know it doesn't look like much, but it's very useful. I could basically take the witch water, and I don't want to do it right now with him here. Could you go away, sir? I'm gonna have to kill him. Boop. Probably not that much. I don't have any of my good tools on me. And you can hear a squid dying in the background. Bam. Bam. Don't blow up. Because if I put down this witch water right now, he's going to turn into a charged creeper. And I really don't want to deal with that. But anytime there was a skeleton in here, I would just, you know, do this. It would push them to the end, turn them into a wither, and then I could kill them. And in doing so, I got myself three drops of evil. So we now have a drop of evil, which is what we needed. We needed that badly. So, we're going to need one more cursed lasso. We're going to need one more regular lasso. And then we should be able to get on with actually getting ourselves angel ring. We just got to catch a ghast. Not a big deal at this point. Need some more gold nuggets. Where they at? There we go. Boop. Throw this here, throw that there, string in here. You know, by process of elimination, was it seriously the last one? Oh, I'm such a derp. Okay. Can't say it enough. Can't wait till I get to AE. I could rush it, but I don't see the point, really. It's just going to make me behind in other things. So we have this now, then we can take this, mix it with a drop of evil. Boom. Cursed lasso. So, we're literally only missing one more part to the angel ring. Angel ring is all we need. We already have a golden lasso with a bat. Bats spawn down there by my mob spawner because it is below, it's down at sea level. Cave level, I guess. It's the way you want to call it. So, the last component is actually just getting a ghast in this cursed lasso. And that shouldn't be that big a deal. But, we're going to build a little hut. Spawn them in, and if we can't get it done, be pretty sweet. We'll have flight pretty early on, and yeah, it's a thing. How big do we want to make it? Doesn't really matter. This is all temporary. Is that three? Yes, it is. Let's do it this size. I just want them nice, safe, controlled, and all that jazz. Probably 4. There we go. And we're going to actually need a few more cobble. Guess I don't even need to worry about the corner. Like I said, this building's very temporary. The second it goes, is done, it's going to be taken down. So I'm not going to worry about the dimensions very much. Boop. I might make a second angel ring just in case I die. Because, you know, ooh. There's mobs down here. I always check if they're skeletons now. If they're skeletons, I always have the chance of getting a wither skull, so That would be pretty cool. But no, just crappy zombies. I really need to pick up my arrows too. Anyway. Nothing there. Nothing. Okay. Go here, put a roof on this, and we're gonna spawn ourselves in a ghast. Okay. Options, music and sound. Where are they? Where's friendly creatures? There we go. No more blazingly loud chicken sounds. I've had enough of that. I've had quite enough. If this all goes well, well, we can get on to something else right away, because I did have something else I wanted to do today, and that is the thing. Let's try this. We'll put a hole like here, and see if we can get him in here controlled, because that'd be wonderful. I really don't want him to die, because then I have to repeat it. So we're going to throw this in here. Boop. Then we're going to immediately throw this in here. Is he taking damage? Can't tell. Don't be taking damage. He took damage. Okay. We're going to have to go get another one. And it's fine if he takes damage. I actually don't mind. I just have to be ready. That is the thing. Where's my golden lasso? Golden lasso. Should have some squids here. They seem to spawn here quite a lot. It doesn't seem to be a problem getting one. Boop. Grab these. Head back up. Try this again. And now that we're all set up, I mean, I can do this very, very easily. So, I probably will make one more. One more, then have a nice safety net in case I die, because I could die in a horrible position and not be able to get it. He shouldn't die this time. We'll see. We'll see. Boop. This. Why won't it let me grab him? I might have to make this a little bigger. We'll try one more time. One more time. One more time for good measure. After I cool down. Oh, the joys of overheating. Gonna be great. I'm pretty sure there's an item that you actually get to carry around with you at some point that takes like an RF charge. And yeah, makes it so you don't overheat. I'm looking really forward to that. That's gonna be a great thing to get to. And the reason this thing is kind of annoying to catch right now is because we need to catch him when I think he's at about I don't know if it's like one health or if it's one health or one heart. It's one of the two. He needs to be weak for us to be able to actually get him in the lasso. So, that is a thing. Bats. Creeper. And a zombie. None. No stuff I care about. Go down here. Grab one of the... Well, grab you. Can you come? There you go. I invite you, sir, to a party. We're going to have a tea party. And... you're invited. Yes, I know I'm running. I shouldn't be. But food isn't a problem for me at all anymore. I'm just going to throw that out there. Like, literally. Literally, no problem at all. See here. Come on. Oh, I'm going to have to make this bigger. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, we got a bigger building. Ready to go. Let's try this. Let's try this one more time. One more time. There he is, and there you go. Simple as that. Easy peasy. There you go. We've got ourselves an angel ring. Look at that, boys. We are all set up. What is this? What is this? Not even that many episodes in. Five or six episodes in, we already got flight. We don't even have power yet, and we already got flight. Well, we got grid power, but that doesn't really count, does it? It doesn't really count. So we're going to need glass, any glass. So two glass. And gold. Grab some gold. 1, 2, 3, 4. Boop. And boop. And boop. Oh, and we still need that. I need 4 redstone. Let's grab 4 redstone. Boop. I did a tiny bit more sieving. I didn't really do much, though, so kind of refilled my iron and some other stuff. I'm damn more. Ooh, I'm going to die. I'm going to die. Not dying is more important than getting an angel ring. Actually, in the long term, if I had a choice between dying and getting an angel ring, I think I'd take the angel ring, but, there we go. We are going to have an angel ring. I'm excited. Ah, here we go. Boom. So, 2 glass, 4 gold, and the resonator. And where did I put those at? In there? No. Are they in here? Nope. Are they in here? Nope. Oh, Lasai. I know I still have two more. I know I have two more. They're probably right in my face. There they are. Boop. And they were right in front of my face. Just like that. Do this. Boop, 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 and boop. And bam. We have an angel ring. And we can fly. We can fly, boys. We have flight. We have creative flight. Just like that. Yeah. I need to go to options. Nope. Can we do that in there? Ooh. That's going to be a problem in this pack. Loaders. Do we have chunk loaders? Chunk. Chunk loader. Extra utility. Oh. That is dirty. Our only choice for a chunk loader. Oh. Environmental tech has a chunk loader? Nope. We're going to have to get to this at some point. Because right now, I can fly around my base. And I can fly for a while. But as soon as this chunk gets unloaded, I'm going to not be flying anymore. And the ability to load chunks isn't in this. Like, say, Sky Factory 3 or anything else. I think this has JEI or not NEI. Or it might be that it has NEI and not JEI. Get a look at the mods here. Options. What option? It's kind of cheaty anyway, I guess, in the long run. JEI has GEI support. Does it have an AI? Yeah, it doesn't have NEI. NEI is the one that adds the cheat menu, I guess, and the... Not even cheat. The utility menu, the recipe menu, and all that other jazz. Okay, and now we're somewhere completely different. We're completely different. We're at the town. We're at the city. I flew here really quick. It must have been before. Oh, I can still fly. Before my chunks unloaded, I put up this little house here real quick so I cool down. The reason we're at the town, I want to, this is what I want to make. There's something from Tinkers I want to make. I've never made one before. This, the seared furnace. I actually want to make a seared furnace. It's good for cooking stacks of items. And since you can't double up on ores in the smeltery, I figured I'd use this. I'd use this and be able to smelt down all my items really quick. And that would be a thing, as well as cook food. I can still fly. I'm a little afraid to fly. But yeah, I'm going to kind of see what we can do. Oh, I see a chest. Let's see what we can get. Nothing. I might as well fly for a bit. I mean, I have the boots. As long as I can... Oh, what is this? That's gotta go. Gas spawner? No thank you. Skeleton spawner? No thank you. Oh, yes. Yes. I want all these... What is that? Ardite? Oh, firewood. Oh, my. Oh, my. I guess these top-level buildings have some nice chests in them. That's not bad at all. I'll take all that stuff. Can I still fly? Yes, I can. I wonder if it's because it's our spawn chunk? That it's actually staying loaded. Because if so, that is awesome. That is awesome. Because I don't think that chunk should still be loaded. Could have something to do with it being the spawn chunk. Oh, free leather? That's good, because I need 8 leather anyway. Free glass? All this free stuff. I like free things. The room of a spider? Don't like that. And, let's go see. I came here for a smeltery, and now I'm full. Okay. I'm gonna do a quick cut. And, I gotta drop stuff off. Okay, I'm back, and I dropped off some stuff, and after 2 more trips after that, I finally remembered to bring arrows. I think this is the smeltery I already grabbed. Yes. So, let's see here. It seems like my flight isn't going away. I don't know if that's going to stay like that or if I'm just being... Ooh. Oh, these faucets. And ardite. That is amazing. isn't going away. So, I'm going to milk it as long as it'll let me. I'm not gonna say no to a gift horse. Or say no? Punch a gift horse in the mouth? Isn't that... That's the saying, I think. Please, please die. Oh, that's beautiful. And if it's like the other ones... Is there a spawner inside? No, this one's safe. Wow, we just got ourselves another spawner very easily. I can't use anything else. And if I keep getting Ardite, I'm going to have a very good pick soon, which will be nice as well. And this should be enough to give us a Seared Furnace, which is really cool. Hey, sir. We need to talk about this. There we go. Is there a spawner here I didn't notice? Yes. Tricky. Okay. These faucets are extremely important. Ooh, leg spike. Is never a good thing. And we're almost finished here, and once I finish up, probably gonna check a few more of these higher level buildings and head on home. We are looking pretty sweet. I'm getting filled up though. Oh, I have my backpack. I could just fill stuff up in my backpack. Boop. And I guess throw this stuff in here. I guess I flew back for nothing. Nothing. Well, I did need arrows either way, I guess, but at least I can carry more stuff. Oh, I did forget to mention that I upgraded that to diamond. The price wasn't really that bad. I mean, it gives you a ton more space, so that's a thing I did. But we're going to check out a couple more chests, and we can always come back at a later point. But, yeah. See if there's anything cool, especially since it seems like my flight's not going to go anywhere. Plus, we'll get tons of these broken spawners, which is probably how we're going to have to... Ooh, cobalt. That's really good, too. Wow. Lots of seared tanks or seared glass. I do approve. Is that a ghast? Nope. If I'm going to get rid of any, I'd like to get rid of those... Ooh. Tool modifiers. Consecrated soil. Oh, I feel like a kid in a candy store. This stuff is so good. So good. I think that consecrated soil is actually used to... Hurt mobs, causes damage to them when they stand on them. I believe. If it is what I think it is. Look here, bam bam, nothing. Maybe check one or two more. I noticed too, sprinting drains your health. Well, when you're sprinting and flying, yeah, that's not an issue. It's not an issue at all. So, it has an added benefit. No, you're a bad man. You are bad men. Nothing there. Gotta break these. Oh, it's a blaze. Really want that gun. Oh. Nothing. Oh. Yes, I will. Oh, so much stuff. There we go. Let's grab some food because I need it desperately. There we go. I never mentioned before too, these brownstone bricks. I didn't notice this the first time I was here. I think it was the second time I came here. These give you speed buffs if you run on them, if they're the same as they used to be. Yes, definitely. They give you a speed buff. If you're looking for something cool to build a pathway out of, you could use those. I don't want to play with you anymore. And I'm overheating. Yeah, I'm going home. I can come back here a later time. And I got distracted on my way home. I saw a pyramid and figured, you know, I got flight now. Let's get her. Let's get her. Oak chest. Also, you should check every time you're in one of these things. Make sure none of the chests say trapped. Make sure none of them say trapped. Apparently, there are some of them that are trapped. So, just make sure you check. Capacitors, golden apple, emerald, sure. This, don't need that stuff. This, I don't know if I'm going to need those or not, but I keep grabbing them. Biome, ash. Ooh, diamonds. More diamonds. I doubt I need this many capacitors, but we'll take them. I have so many of these capacitors now, probably enough to fill a chest. Boop, 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 and boop, and boop. Ooh, wand of traveling. I'll take that. That's pretty good. And finally, we'll head home. Okay, and I'm back. I'm back, safe and sound. Everything's good in the world, and I'm still flying. I'm still flying and loving it. Yeah, my flight never went out, so I don't know why. But I'm not going to risk it at nighttime until I am sure that my flight isn't just going to give out randomly. Because it could. Because I believe if that chunk gets unloaded, it's going to stop working. But yeah, let's get to our seared furnace. Actually, let's get to something. No, let's get to seared furnace. I'm such a derp. We're going to do the seared furnace. We're going to do it like right here, I think. And I was thinking a 5x5. 5x5 sounds good. That's 3. That's 5. There we go. And that. There we go. I love that I can pick up that now. None of that sand is actually in my inventory. Where is it? It's all in here. All in here compressed. It's awesome. Look at how much compressed sand just builds up. Takes no time. Yeah, so this is where we're going to put it. We're going to try 5x5. I don't know if I have enough blocks. I have not mapped it, so. Worst case scenario, I'm going to vulture pieces from that. Because I will be heading back to the city anyway, so it's not a big deal. Probably do that between videos. Head to the city and do a little more adventuring. Controller probably go there, tank there. Oop. No. That does not work. Go. Do I have a wand? Wand would speed that up. Boop. And boop. That's that. We are going to need some more. Don't know how many more, so let's do this. That. I don't know if these corners need to be here. It sounded like it. It said something about frame, so I'm not sure exactly. What's it say? Structure can be made using blocks of any kind with a single controller. The ceiling can be swapped out for slabs or stairs. That's kind of cool to know. Does it mean seared slabs? Here. Is there a seared slab? There is. We might try that later on. Because then I wouldn't have to worry about lighting it up. But we'll do this first and then experiment later. I'll probably do the experiment in between videos. That's what I tend to do. Although this is kind of an experiment in itself because, well, I've never done this before at all. I'm going to have to vulture. Make it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, this is going to be the roof anyway, so I don't need that many. Boop. We'll just vulture from here. Did I put more of these in here? Because I did drop off some of the bits and bobs. Oh, there's 6 seared bricks. Yeah. Give us a bit more. I'd like to get one with that many tanks. I wonder if all those tanks link up. Oh, stop that. Stop. Stop the horrible things you're doing. You're giving people problems. Mostly me. There we go. And we just need a few more and we're done. Remember to place the torch. Remember to place the torch. I have to remind myself by repeating it over and over. It's a thing. Yep. And if this thing works the way that they make it sound like it does, I'm barely going to need this anyway. This is going to be purely for alloys. And even then, it's only going to be for alloys until I get the alloy smelter. So I might not have to use the smeltery very much, which is nice. Throw that there. Throw that there. It's doing that, so it is working. That is cool. So, yeah, we need to test this. Let's get some more. I'm just going to do it with a bunch of cobble. And I actually think I'm going to take this. Throw away all that lovely lava, but it doesn't really matter. And we're going to plug that in right here. Right here. Boop. Boop. Then it would have to be crucible. Boop. And then a hopper. Boop. and then this. Can we go up? There we go. I probably move that over to this side so I can fill both with lava very easily. And I guess all I really need is a fluid transfer node. Oop. Let's do this. Fluid transfer node. So two redstone, two stone, and a bucket. So two redstone. Do I have any stone on me? Of course not. Why would I have lovely stone? Stone. Bucket. There's a bucket. This will use this one up. I gotta be aware of that. I'd like to keep at least two buckets at all times. I think that's everything. Fluid transfer? Nope. Not retrieval. Too expensive. That'll give us four of those, and we'll need one of those. So let's just throw those on the bar right away. We are gonna need them. Almost nighttime. Boop. And boop. There we go. Oop. Don't want to do that. And I want to test this puppy out. Wow, it holds a lot. Is that still going in? Yes. How much inventory does this thing? Oh my goodness. This thing has a massive. Could you imagine? And the items, where do they go? Oh. Okay, I see. You gotta pull them out. So I just... They're mine now. That is cool. I'm actually... That is amazing. I really like this. That is really cool. Why haven't I used this before? Sleep really quick. And there you go. There we go. That is amazing. I'm really happy with this. I'm really happy. And if I take you and put you, I guess, no, I can't do that. I'd have to move the smeltery drain. We might wait on that. I'll just rearrange this. I need the smeltery drain moved. Then once the smeltery drain is moved, I can pipe it right in here. I just throw the other seared tank there and fill them both with lava constantly. They'll never have to worry about lava for either of these with one setup, which is really cool. And I did tell myself to put torches down over and over and over. So let's do that. The blood moon will come and bad things will happen. And on top of this too, at the end of this video, I'll be tearing this down anyway. I'll probably get one more ghast. Just so I have a backup angel ring. And yeah, that is awesome. This is awesome. I have flight. I have flight in this world of horrible. And I can move fast now. This is so beautiful. This is the best part of this. I mean, it not using food is awesome. Not using food, because I haven't been able to sprint all game, and it's been driving me insane. Driving me insane. But I don't have to worry about that anymore, because, well, food is not as much an issue anymore at all. And flying isn't going to make me waste it, so that is a thing. And what else? There was one more thing I wanted to take a look at. It was because someone mentioned it in one of the comments of my last videos, earlier today, actually. And I actually want to try this, the ore smasher. Let's try the ore smasher, because if it does what he says, it sounds pretty useful. And I've never used it. I've never used the thing. We're gonna try it out. Boom, boom. And I've never seen anyone else use this either, so I don't think it's a very overly common known thing. But if we're gonna be doing manual sieving, oh no. I noticed these two. One of these two. I didn't notice when I was grabbing them. They're the for the tank. The actual giant tank for Tinkers. Which I've also never had to use. We won't use it in this pack because there's not enough fluids. But in some packs, that's going to be very useful too. But yeah, it lets you put all your fluids in one tank. And they won't mix like they will in a smeltery. So you don't have to worry about mixing. Great way to be able to store your fluids really easy. What will we need? Need two sticks. I need eight of these and a diamond. Let's grab one diamond. Boop, boop, boop. Check this out. Boop, boop. Bam. And bam. No, bam. Yes, ore smasher from Expressum. That looks pretty cool. threw gold on the ground because I am just so rich. And let's grab something that we can do this with. And maybe a different one? I want to see how it works exactly. It's supposed to auto-craft your blocks for you. That is the idea behind it. Your chunks. You're basically your chunks. And I want to see how it works. See here? So right-click. It does do it too. That is cool. That is such a time saver. Oh my goodness. I can't remember the name whoever told me about that, but will you marry me? No, not really, but thank you very much. That was an awesome tip. That's going to save me tons of time. Tons of time, because I was going to actually make a second backpack and have to reconfigure it every time to do that. So if I was doing gravel, I'd have to do a setup. If I was doing sand, I was going to do a setup. And dust, I'd have to do a setup. I'd have to change the filters every time I wanted to use it. This eliminates that, and that is beautiful. That is beautiful. I mean, now I can just boop and boop, grab all those bits, and bam. Like, that saves so much time. So much time. Oh. And yeah, if you're doing, 100 of those, 100, worth of smelting or breaking it down, that's going to save you so much time. That is ridiculous. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, good sir. You are a gentleman and a scholar. Okay, I think that pretty much sums it up for this video. I think we are pretty much done. I think we're done. We made a lot of progression today. A lot of progression. We got our angel ring, of course. Got our sweet little angel ring. It's weird. This thing says it has durability, but I'm not using it to actually hammer ores. The right-clicking doesn't actually affect its durability, which is amazing. Totally amazing. It'll last forever because I won't use it to actually smash ores. So that is really cool. Just thought I'd throw that out there. Yeah, we made tons of progression. Tons of progression. We got an angel ring. We got our seared furnace, which is going to... This thing's going to see a lot of use. A lot of use in this pack. And very happy to have it. I mean, even when I get to automating sieving, I'm probably still going to pipe stuff into this because it's going to be the fastest and easiest route, I think. I might end up making it bigger. And and we got this cool little ore smasher. So, I mean, we made a lot of progression. I'm happy with my progression. It's kind of how I judge my videos. I try to always hit a, decent level of progression. And I'm happy with my progression, and I hope you guys are too. And as always, if you guys like this video, please leave a like. If you really liked it, hit that subscribe button. I'll come to your house and, stare at you awkwardly. Anyway, I'm going to take off. I want you guys all to have a good one. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Later.